the most news in the morning. 38 minutes past the hour right now. Patients in the U.S. schedule more than 900 million doctor visits each year. And the average amount of time that you actually get to spend with your doctor, 13 minutes.
The missing personal touch can lead to mistakes, miscommunication, and that can be hazardous to your health. So how can you be sure that you're getting the best care during each appointment? Weekly column that you've been doing for CNN.com, but the inspiration for this really was a situation with your mother, who was in end-stage renal failure, recently had a kidney transplant.
That's right. She got a kidney transplant in December, and we're very
at a very, very vulnerable time for you. You just had a newborn baby. She had to be in the NICU, the intensive care unit for newborns, and you realized that she was getting spinal taps after the doctor said she didn't need them anymore, and you couldn't sort of bridge that gap between
spinal taps. She said, oh, no, she is. She's getting another one in an hour, and you have to leave. Visiting hours are over, and I was just so upset. I just given birth that I just cried and cried and cried, and about an hour later.
Those situations, I mean, did you get lucky that this other nurse was willing to hear you out?
Oh, I was very lucky.
That of your mother. My brother died because his doctor wouldn't give him an x-ray that would have discovered the lymphoma in his chest at the earliest stage. But so you're saying you
advocate for yourself usually. So go in there, be a bad patient, annoy people.
I mean, it seems like a double-edged sword. You can Google anything, any medical condition on the internet these days and just read and read and hear horror stories and the whole nine yards. At the same token, it is helpful to be informed when you go to your doctor. But how do you approach, you know, a doctor's visit when you do have concerns, you've maybe read about things, you maybe don't necessarily believe the diagnosis you've been given? How do you make sure that that's a productive conversation?
Right, because there's this huge, I call it the biggest divide between doctors and patients right now. Everyone's on down what your questions are.
Yeah, it's always good, too, to just come in with like a real good sense of what it is that's troubling you, as opposed to saying, I've got a pain, you know, describe it a little more.
Yes, absolutely.
Great to see this one. Give me the book so I can hold it up.
Oh, sure, there you go.
All right, Elizabeth Cohen, here, sir, the new book, The Empowered Patient. And it's really a terrific little guide to tell you how you can help get yourself the best medical care. Great to see you. Congratulations.
Great. Thank you.
Thanks, Elizabeth.
And next month, tune into Elizabeth's special report, The Empowered Patient, Taking Control of Your Health Care.